Welcome back to the channel. I want to show you guys about node stacks. This is a new feature that just came out on one of the most recent updates. And let me walk you through the node tree here. We look over here, we have two dots. One is your clip and the other one is your timeline. So how that works is we look here, all these nodes kind of have this reddish orange outline. And that's a clip based node. We go over to timeline here, I'll add a serial. You can see it's got a blue outline. How this works is everything on your timeline will now be affected by whatever's on this node. A good way to use this would be like a film grain or a vignette, which I've shown on another video. Let's just leave it like that. Now you can see if we go to each shot, they all have the same vignette. So it's good for global options. Now on this first clip, I put a little change to it and I have a version saved. Here's the first one. Here's the second one with a little bit of like blue reduction taken out of his shirt in the background. And happen to have this node tree on here. How this would work is if you had your base look going, maybe you had a couple versions saved and you were going to work with somebody else, for example, and let's say they wanted to make some adjustments and you wanted to maintain everything. Normally what I would do is go to the timeline and I would right click it and duplicate it and save it as a version. So any edits or any changes are made will be on the newest version. And you can always go back a version. However, with node stacks, you can do that in a way with your color. So this is a project specific. So we're gonna go to this gear icon in the bottom right, or you can hit Shift-9. That pops up your project settings. And under general options, under color, we have node stack layers. And you can go up to 4. I'll choose 2. You can actually label them. So I'll call this second one director. And then you also have an option for post group node stack. So if you're making groups, this would give you an option after the group. So I'm hit save. Now we have another bubble over here or another dropdown. We have clip L1, clip director, and then timeline. So if we go to director, this one happens to have the same node tree because I was in here earlier. But if we go to the second clip, and you can see we're on the director layer, it's just got the single node because that's how it goes by default. So I actually added it to layer 2 here. Well, let's say we took out this particular one. We added a couple of parallel nodes and a couple serial nodes. And you can label your nodes by right-clicking and choose Label Node. I actually have it as a tab key, so I can just label it quickly. So let's say under the director node stack, he wants it a little more contrasty. So you make this change. And now within this whole stack here, you could take these on and off. And that would allow you to make these changes under a director layer. And then if you had other deliveries or more changes were made, you could output this director version. Then you could come back in here, disable that, and now you could just release and render the original version. So it's a great way to use stacks if you're working with other people or you're making, say, separate deliveries for different color spaces, anything like that. So those are some good use case scenarios for using these layers. I haven't gotten it too much into my workflow yet, but it's nice to know that option's there. Under preferences, it is project specific, so you'll have to go in and make this like your default project settings. Anytime you create a new project, you could have this saved, but you got to do that from like a scratch template project. All right, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next one.